Okay, children, good morning to one and all. Students, today we are going to discuss one activity. Before discuss the activity, I would like to introduce myself. Students, this is E. Venkateshwarlu, SA Bioscience, ZPSS, Aragudam, Nelakondapalli Mandal, Khammam District. Okay, students, now we are going to discuss our topic. Before discuss the topic, our topic start with questionnaire method. Okay, students, now I would like to ask one question. Ready to say the answer. Okay, children, what is the, who discovered the cell? Okay, students, who discovered the cell? Already you know, you learnt in the 8th standard and also discussed in the first lesson of the 9th class also. Okay, students, who discovered the cell? Okay, students, I will give three options. Ready to say. Option A, Robert Brown. Option B, Robert Hooke. Next, Robert C. Option, Robert Hill. Okay, students, among these three options, which is the correct one? Already you know. What is the correct one? The correct answer is Robert Hooke. Okay, students, the cell first discovered by Robert Hooke, scientist. Okay, students, next I would like to ask another question. Ready to say the answer, students. What is the structural unit of organism? Okay, students, already you know. What is the structural unit of the organism? Right, students. Now also, I will give the three options. Option A, organ. B, organ system. C, cell. Okay, students, which is the correct one? Cell. Cell is the correct one. Okay, students, the cell is called as the structural unit of organism. Okay, students, why the cell is called as structural unit of the organism? Because the cell construct the total organism. The cell involved in construction of the organism, like the brick to construct the building. Okay, students, already you know, to construct the building, the bricks play very very important role. Okay, like the brick role in construction of the building, the cell also play the very very important role to construct the organism. So the total body of the organism is constructed by cell. That's why the cell is called as the structural unit of the organism. Okay, do you understand, students? The cell is called as structural unit of the cell. Okay, students, now again I would like to ask another question. What is the another question? Another question is, what is the functional unit of the organism? Okay, students, already I think you know what is the functional unit of the organism. What is the functional unit of the organism? Okay, students, now also I will give three options. Again, A, organ. B, organ system. And C, cell. Okay, students, among these three options, which is the correct one? Yes, students, the cell is the correct answer. So the cell is called as the functional unit of the organism. Why the cell is called as functional unit of the organism? Because in organism, many metabolic activities are occurred. Many metabolic activities are held in organism, like respiration, excretion, reproduction, muscle contraction. Okay, these all metabolic activities are occurred in the cell. And the same way, the length of the organism, the size of the organism, the color of the organism, these all are controlled by some factors. What? The factors control the functions of the organ, the size of the organ, the length of the organ, and total metabolic activities. All are controlled by particular factors. What are the factors? the factors are called as genes. The genes are present in the nucleus. What is the location of the nucleus? The nucleus present in the cell. Okay, students, the total activities are controlled by genes. The genes are present in the nucleus. Nucleus present in the cell. So, students, the cell is called as the functional unit of the organism. Okay, students, already we know who discovered the cell, what is the structural unit of the organism, and what is the functional unit of the organism. Already you know. Okay, students, do you see the cell? Whenever do you see the cell? Okay, students, I think some students may be seen, because in 8th class standards, the cell, the microscope and cells may be seen. Okay, a few students only may be seen, but now I show the cell and the size of the cell, structure of the cell to the all the students. So, students, ready to see. Okay, students, okay, how do we see the cell? The cell is generally very small in size. But how do we see, which apparatus need to see the micro size objects? Generally, you know, the micro size objects are seen by special apparatus, that is known as microscope. Okay, students, this is the microscope. Okay, students, to see the cell, we need some required materials. Okay, first of all, we need the microscope. This is the microscope. Already you know, you learnt in 8th standard, this is the microscope. The microscope need to see the cell. Okay, students, the another materials also need to see the cell. First one, next to, already you know, what is the name of this one? This is the slide. Okay, this is the transparent rectangle shaped part. This is known as slide. The slide also required to see the cell. So, students, microscope, next to slide. After, we need another apparatus. This is the another material. This is known as cover slip. This is also transparent squared shaped material. This is known as cover slip. Okay, students, after to see the cells in the microscope, another materials also need. Okay, this is also need. This is the needle. Already you know the needle. Next one, scissor. The scissor also essential. This is the scissor. Next to chalk. Okay, this is the chalk. The chalk also essential. Next one, this is the brush. The brush also need to see the cell in the microscope. Next one, this is the onion peel. Okay, students, next, this is the one strain. The strain is very, very essential to see the cells clearly. To appear the clearly, this strain is very, very important. This is known as safranin. Okay, safranin. Next one, this is the another chemical. This is known as glycerin. The glycerin also need to observe the cell in the microscope. Okay, students, already I introduced the required materials which are need to observe the cell. First of all, microscope slide, cover slip, needle, brush, safranin, glycerin, onion. Okay, these all are need. So these are the required materials. Okay, students, already you know the required material. Okay, what method, what procedure we have to follow to see the cell? Okay, students, first of all, we have to follow the one systematic procedure to observe the cell, students. Okay, which cell we have to see, we can see easily? Okay, as for our 10th, okay, students, in our 9th standard, the onion peel cells activity already given in our 9th textbook. Okay, students, this is the onion. Okay, now we are going to see the cells in the onion peel. Okay, students, now Now we are going to discuss the procedure. First of all, we have to take the microscope, students. In the procedure, first we have to take the microscope and prepared well to observe the cell. Okay, next students, we have to take the petri dish. Already you know this is the petri dish. Second step, you have to take the petri dish and take the water and pour the water in the petri dish. Like, okay students, we have to pour the water in the petri dish. Okay students, after we have to take the chalk and onion. With the help of chalk, we have to separate the onion peels. Already you know many the onion consists of many peels. Okay, first of all, we have to separate the peels from the onion. Okay students, this is the one onion peel. Okay students, the onion peel generally has the two surfaces. This is the lower surface, this is the upper surface. Okay students, this is the lower surface. This shape also called as concave shape. This is the convex shape. Okay students, from the onion peel, we have to remove the one transparent layer. To remove the transparent layer from the onion peel, first of all, we have to bend the onion peel toward the upper surface or toward the convex shape. When we bend the onion peel toward the outer surface, see the students, now one transparent layer came. Okay, this is the transparent layer. Okay, students, this transparent layer, with the help of scissor, we have to detach from the onion peel and keep in the water which is present in the petri dish. Okay students, I keep the onion peel, transparent onion peel in the petri dish okay, this is the transparent layer. The transparent layer keep in the water which is present in the petri dish. Okay students, after we have to remove, okay, this transparent layer came clear only. This transparent layer transferred from the water to slide. Okay, with the help of brush and needle, we have to transfer the transparent layer of the onion peel from the water to slide. Okay students, why we have to keep the transparent layer of the onion peel into water? Otherwise maybe the transparent layer become dry. If the transparent layer become dry, the cells in onion peel not visible clearly. That's why we have to keep the transparent layer of the onion peel in the water. After transfer the transparent layer of the onion peel from the water to slide, we have to take the one strain. Okay students, this is the strain. This strain is known as safranin. The safranin strain, we have to pour one drop of safranin strain on the transparent layer of the onion peel which is present on the slide. Okay students, listen carefully, see the video clearly. Okay, I pour the safranin, pour the safranin drops on the transparent layer of the onion peel which is present on the slide. Okay students, after we have to wait 10 to 15 seconds. After 10 to 15 seconds, with the help of needle, we have to press the transparent layer with the help of needle and wash the saffron color. We have to wash the transparent layer to remove the color of the strain. Okay students, now I wash the transparent layer to remove the saffronin strain. Okay students, after wash the transparent layer, next we have to take cover slip. Okay, students, this is the transparent layer. Okay, students, next to we have to take the glycerin. Okay, students, we have to drop one drop on the glycerin. Why we have to take the glycerin on the transparent layer? Okay, students, we have, okay, whenever we take the glycerin on the transparent layer, then only more time, long time wetting state. Otherwise, the maybe the transparent layer of the onion peel may be dry. If the transparent layer of the onion peel may dry, then the cells not appeared clearly. That's why to avoid the dryness, we have to add the glycerin. Okay, students, already I added the glycerin to the transparent layer of the onion peel, which is present on the slide. After I take cover slip. Okay, students, this is the cover slip, already you know. Okay, this cover slip you have to keep on the transparent layer of the onion peel like this. Okay, students, see the video. How do I keep on the keep the cover slip on the transparent layer? Okay, students, after the slide, this slide have to bring near the microscope and see the this transparent layer and observe the this transparent layer in the microscope. Okay, students, already you know the microscope has the two lens. Okay, this is the optic lens. Okay, students, next to here also some lens are present. They are called as object lens. The okay, just below the object lens, one platform is present. Okay, in this platform we have to keep the slide in the platform of the microscope. This is also called as slide platform, slide stage. Okay, students, next we have to adjust the microscope and see the and observe the transparent layer of the onion peel like this. Okay, first we have to adjust. After adjustment, we have to observe the onion peel cells. Okay, students, listen carefully. Already you see okay, some brick like structures are appeared in this part. Okay, students, listen carefully. In this onion peel, the onion peel consists of some rectangle shaped brick like structures are appeared in this microscope. They are arranged, they appeared as they look like a wall and bricks. Okay, this is appeared clearly. Okay, students, this videos all of you see and draw the diagram in the notebook, students, and write the cells of onion peel. Listen carefully, these are the cells in the onion peel. Okay, they are look like a bricks in the wall. See the students, these are the cells. They are the rectangle in shape. They are arranged one above another one. Okay, these are the cells. Okay, these cells, this diagram, see and draw the diagram in our notebook. Okay, students, once again listen carefully and see the picture very very carefully. Okay, students, the cell has the outline. The outline also called as, that is the one membrane that is known as plasma membrane. Okay, students, the plasma membrane absorb the safranin strain, that's why that is the thick in color. Okay, students, this is the cell in onion peels. Everyone see the this picture and draw the diagram in our notebook. Okay, students, do you see clearly? Right. Okay, students, today we are discuss about the activity. How do we see the cells in the onion peel? Okay, students, I think you understand all the activity, what are the materials, what is the procedure we have to follow, how do you see, what is the size of the cell, what is the shape of the cell. I think already you know by this activity. Okay, students, sometimes in examinations this question very very important. If the question asked in the examination, how do you write in the exams, how the question arise in the exams. Okay, generally this activity asked in the examination as how do you see the cells in onion peel in your school laboratory. Okay, this question generally will come. Otherwise sometimes what procedure you have to follow to see the cells in the onion peel. Okay, this question also sometimes asked, and sometimes asked as what precautions, what procedure and what write the observation and procedure to see the cells in the onion peel. Okay, these like questions generally asked in the examinations. If the question asked in the examination, we have to write the answer in 5 steps. First one, aim. Second one, require material or apparatus. Third one, procedure. Next, fourth one, observation. Fifth one, determination or inference. Okay, students, you have to write the answer in these 4 or 5 steps only. Then only you will get the full marks, students. Okay, how do we write the aim? Aim, what is the question? How do you see the cells in onion peel in your school laboratory? This is the question. Then, how do you write the aim? The aim, you have to write that to see the cells in the onion peel. Okay, that is the aim. Okay, next, required materials. What required materials used in your activity already you know. What materials are used? Okay, you have to write the total materials which are used in the activity. First, we are used the materials like microscope, already you know, microscope, slide, cover slip, needle, brush, petri dish, watch glass, saffronin, strain, next glycerin, these materials used. So you have to write as a second step these materials. Okay, students, next you have to write the third step, that is the procedure. Okay, students, already you know how do you write the procedure. In the procedure, first you have to write, first of all we have to take the microscope. First of all, I take microscope and prepared well to see the cell. After second step, you have to take the petri dish. Next, pour the water in the petri dish. After, we have to take the onion and chalk. After, we have to separate the onion peels from the onion with the help of chalk. Okay, after we have to bend the onion peel toward the upper side, outer surface, towards the outer surface, then one transparent layer will come. Okay, this transparent layer detach from the onion peel and keep in the water which is present in the petri dish. Okay, students, after the transparent layer transfer from the water into slide, after we have to drop the saffronin on the transparent layer which is present on the slide. Okay, after we have to keep this setup 10 to 15 minutes. After, students, we have to wash the transparent layer with the water with the help of needle. After, we have to keep the cover slip on the transparent layer and see the transparent layer in the microscope. Okay, students, this is the procedure you have to write in the exams. Next, you have to write the observation, students. How do you write the observation? Observation that you have to write that, okay, whenever I see the transparent layer of the onion peel in the microscope, some brick-like structures are appeared or visible in the transparent layer of the onion peel in the microscope. That is the procedure. Sorry, that is the observation, students. Next, you have to write last step, determination or inference. Determination, write as for above observation, I determine the size and shape of the cells of onion peel in the microscope. Okay, students, this is the last step, determination. Okay, whenever you write the these five steps, then only you will get the full marks, students. So don't forget, you have to write the total five steps. Once again, I will repeat. See the listen carefully and write in the notebook, students. Seriously, first aim. Okay, next required materials, students. Next one procedure after observation. Next one, students, determination. These five steps are very, very important. Then only you will get the full mark, students. Next, students, sometimes this question asked as a give the diagram and ask the questions below the diagram. Okay, sometimes asked as the only observations. Sometimes asked as only procedure. Okay, students, if you prepared well, then you will write any type of you will write the answer to any type of the question. So, students, you first of all, you listen the video well and prepare the notebook own. Okay, students, then only you will get the permanent knowledge. So, students, this video, see the repeatedly and write the notebook seriously and prepare well, students. So this is the pandemic situation. That's why this is only alternative method, students. That's why don't neglect these YouTube classes. That's why all students have to see seriously. Okay, seriously and write the examination, students. Okay, thank you giving this opportunity. First of all, thankful to our district DEO Madan Mohan sir and this program coordinate conveners Anita madam and Srinivas sir and coordinators, the biology coordinators Repala Srinivas Rao sir and my friends Ranjit Kumar and Don Bosco, who are helped to me to conduct this activity. So thankful to all of them. Okay, sir, thank you giving this opportunity.